हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। लेट्स से हाउ टू सिमुलेट 180 डिग्री हाइब्रिड इन क्यूसीएस। सो फ्रॉम द सर्किट डायग्राम आई हैव कनेक्टेड द कनेक्शंस हियर, सो यू कैन सी हाउ टू टेक द कंपोनेंट्स। लेट अस ब्रीफ एक्सप्लेनेशन लाइक गो टू कंपोनेंट्स। हियर यू कैन सेलेक्ट सोर्सेस। सो फर्स्ट यू नीड टू हैव ए पावर सोर्स। सो फॉर द पावर सोर्स इन द सोर्सेस मेनू यू कैन सी द पावर सोर्स, जस्ट प्लेस एंड जस्ट and just connect using this wire. Okay, so you just connect this point, click on it and then click on this like this, so you can get that. Next, so if you want how the basics and all works, you can see my first video. I have mentioned how it works, how to connect and all, or otherwise you can also watch the previous experiments that I have uploaded, so you'll get an idea here. And you can see here that first you need another transmission line. For the transmission line, go to transmission lines, and the first one is that transmission line, and just place everything in place and just connect using the wire. For now, coming to the port declaration, here actually there is, in when you see the circuit, this entire thing will be inside a port, okay, these two terminals, but we won't see this transmission line in the circuit. Okay, for the to declare it as a port, or to make some, to define it as a port, or to make it as a port, we have to take a arbitrary transmission line with an arbitrary length of 10 millimeters. So, and also by only 10, I can take 100 and all. So, if we increase the value further, what happens? The value will be not that approximate value is not. So basically, if you have more, for example, now if I get it as 4.999, when you increase the length of the transmission, you might get as 4.7, like that. So there is a huge change. So that's why make as small as possible. So that's one thing. Next, coming to you, what is the impedance that you need to? So what is the impedance that is port has? That is, if the port has the Z naught impedance. So every port will have a Z naught impedance, and the Z naught given in this question was 50 ohms. That's why I have taken 50 ohms. And coming to the main part of the circuit, okay, apart from the transmission line. So in these four transmission lines, here the values are Z naught by 3, I think. So, or Z naught by root 3, or Z naught, it depends. Okay. So Z naught root 2, I think. So what happens? We need to we need to calculate that value. Okay, corresponding to the circuit, you just calculate the Z value of this transmission line that will be shown in the circuit. Like this will be a Z naught by 3. Example, let us take an example. I didn't have the circuit, so that's why I'm not able to show you now. So basically, when it comes to 180 degree hybrid, it will be looking like a circular thing, and it has a of length lambda by 4, lambda by 4, lambda by 4, and 3 lambda by 4. So depending on that, it will change. Okay, and also that lambda 4 all will have some equal impedances. So I think it is Z naught root 2, but when it comes to the length of the transmission line, it varies with when it comes to the length, it will be a lambda. Okay, we'll take in terms of lambda, the length will be calculated using the wavelength. So how to find the wavelength is, they will give some operating frequency of the circuit. Let us take for this circuit, it might be some 50 kilo gigahertz or 10 gigahertz, like that. So from that we can calculate frequency, we can calculate wavelength. From that wavelength you can calculate the length of the transmission line. So maybe it will be lambda by 4, lambda by 4, lambda by 4, 3 lambda, like that. Got the point, right? Or something like that, it will be there. So depending on the circuit, like on the circuit of the part or the connection between these two ports, port 1 and port 2. For example, here the port 1 and port 2 are connected using a transmission line, this transmission line. So are connected using a transmission line with a length of some lambda by 4 or lambda by in that way. Okay. So this is how you have to do this. Now coming to the simulation part, or now how to edit those values. Basically, right click on the component, edit properties, go to click on Z, just change the value of Z. If you want to change the length of the transmitter, click on L and you just change the value, how much millimeter or how much meters the length is. Click apply. Okay. You have to do this the same to everything. If you want to change the properties of the power, edit power, go to the Z, change the impedance. No need to touch that PEF and all for now. Okay, so that's how you need to do. Now coming to the S parameter, how to simulate for the S parameters. First you need to have some block called S parameters. The simulation that will be found in the simulations menu. So here, out of this, select simulation. This is SParam, so select that and place it over here. That's it. Now you are good to go. But my advice is here, what you can do is basically you can change the what type of transmission simulation you want. You want a linear, you want logarithmic, least constant, like that. And if you want to have start this x axis basically from 1.5 to some stop value 2.5 gigahertz, okay. With this, how much step size you need to have, and also how many points. Okay, so if you have more number of points, you will get more accurate graph, smooth curve, because the interval between each two points will be less. No? So you will get some more accurate. But when you try to see the output, it will have many output, many outputs for a small range itself. So now coming to simulation, just click on this gear symbol. When you click on this, you won't get like this graphs initially. You will get only this 1 minute. Just accidentally I have deleted this power. So now simulate. So when you simulate, we'll get those all the graphs. Like initially you won't get everything, will be blank when you open. So how to get the graph, click on the Cartesian here. So place it over here. It will ask you which graph do you want, S1 and S2. If you find, like if you have to double click to activate that. So if I do semi graph, like for every S1 one graph, S2 one graph, like this it will come. One graph it will come. You just place them in order. So if I want some few set of types in only one graph, for example all S1 is first row, outputs of first row elements values can be seen here in a single graph. Like selecting whichever graph do you need, just double click on that, it will be added into this query. Now click apply, press OK, you will see that all the graphs of S11, S12, S23, S4 are present here, and you can identify which graph corresponds to it with the color code. Okay, so this is how you need to simulate 180 degrees phase shift, 180 degrees hybrid. So thanks for watching. For more you can subscribe to my channel. Thank you.